time for high school basketball game night. Now here's your play-by-play announcers for tonight's game.
Hello and welcome to Dothan High School, where we are here where the Northview Cougars are taking on the Dothan Tigers. As you can see, we have a full house here tonight, and I tell you what, you better have on your seat belt, your shoulder harnesses, and any kind of restraints you can put on, because this game is going to be a big game tonight. Dothan's leading the area with 2-0. Northview is 1-1. So this is a big area game. These teams have split this year. Northview won in the Carroll High tournament, and Dothan won at Northview. And you better believe Northview want to come over here in Dothan's home gym and upset them.
Oh, yeah, that's a huge rivalry, man. It's going to be a fun game to watch for sure.
So Northview wins the tip. And Dothan steals the ball, and Northview turn it over on that first possession. You're going to see an up-tempo game tonight.
Well, you know you're going to see a lot of defense from Dothan High. They're known for that.
Tyreek Lindsey. Lindsey shoots, won't go, and he hustles and gets his own rebound. And Northview swarming. Morris, he's fouled. That foul is on number 3. That is A.J. Williams.
They're playing tough down there around the basket, man. It's a lot of intensity.
Morris. Devin Morris, number 20. Believe it or not, he's a 10th grader. Both of these teams are kind of young. So Morris hits 1 of 2.
Big man for Northview snagging the rebound. Good size on him.
Harris over to AJ. And he loses it out of bounds, so Northview has committed 2 early turnovers.
Like I said before, that defensive pressure for Dothan High, they're known for it. Coach Brown teaches it well.
Dothan is coached by Emmanuel Brown, and Northview is coached by Janeski Flemings. Three-second violation called against Dothan. Starting lineup for Northview is number 3, A.J. Williams, number 4, Billy Ford, number 5, Jastaro Reynolds, number 13, Jarrell Harris, and number 23, Malik Johnson. Billy Ford. Johnson's up. And there's a foul that's going to be called on Jordan Small, his first. Team's first. We played about a minute and a half, and no field goals. Dothan has 1 point from Kevin Morris. He made 1 of 2 from the foul line. A.J. Williams for a 3. Won't go. Ballard for the rebound. Lindsey comes out with it. To Williams on the break.
Oh.
Good hustle that time by Tyrese Lindsey for 2.
Both teams looking at taking it to the hole here. Although the 1-3 taken by Northview.
Billy Ford. Into Reynolds, and he draws the foul. Foul is on Chris Graham, his first.
Don't want to get him in foul trouble. That's one of their bigs.
Reynolds is at the foul line for Northview. And he makes the first. Their last meeting, Northview had a 14-point lead on Dothan, and Dothan came from behind and won it by 6. So Jastaro Reynolds puts Northview on top by 1, 2-1. Williams, nice bank off the glass for 2. Tyson Williams, a 9th grader. AJ Williams goes for the 3. Yes, count it. Northview, and we're tied at five apiece, and Northview steals the ball.
I'll tell you what, Northview looks pretty good out the gate, Mitt. They got to continue to do this, but so far, so good for them.
Both of these teams are very talented. And the thing I like about them, they play very hard. Tyson Williams, layup for two. 4 points for Williams. Northview go up, Dothan go up by 2, 7-5. Shot up, won't go. Good rebound, a good follow-up. And a layup that time for number 13, Terrell Harris. That was a great hustle by Harris. Williams. He's going to take it to him.
Oh.
Gets his rebound. Hustles. And it's going to be out of bounds off Northview. .459 left in the opening period. We're tied at 7 apiece. Jordan Small takes the ball out for the Tigers into Tyson Williams. Chris Graham into Morris. Morris goes up off the glass and it rolls in.
Nicely executed play too. Just a simple post up. And he feeds it to him and converts on the easy basket. Gotta love that.
Dothan up 9-7. Northview comes right back. Goes into the big man. He misses and it's gonna be out off Northview. Cliff, I don't know if you heard me say number 24 for Dothan is a ninth grader.
Wow.
Tyrez. Small goes up. He had to change his shot because Johnson had those arms stretched out high. Lindsay misses but gets his own rebound and passes over to Graham. Graham is fouled. That foul was on number 23, which is Johnson. Chris Graham is at the line and he made his first of two. Dothan's up by 3, 10-7. Graham makes 1 of 2, and it's rebounded by Jaylene Thomas. Malik Johnson, turnaround jumper, won't go, rebounded by Morris. Tyson Williams. Goes up, shoots, and he's fouled. That foul is on number 21, Jaylene Thomas, his first. At the line is Tyson Williams. He has 4 points. He misses the first of two. He makes the second. That gives him 5 points. And Dothan 11. Northview 7. Malik Johnson pulls up for the jumper. Won't go. And we have a foul. Cliff, get down where they are. Tyson, Williams, Perez, Lindsay. Good guess it was a three-second violation?
I'm not sure. I really ain't sure. I think you're right, though. I think he was just hanging out down there while he's taking the ball down.
Mitchell. Reynolds. Nice feed down to Billy Ford for two. And that foul is on number four, Lindsay. So Ford makes it a three-point play. We're down to 3 minutes. Dothan leads by one, 11-10. Williams goes and misses. And it's rebounded by Reynolds, and he tries to hit Creel. Sean Holmes, and he overthrows him.
And I'm pretty impressed with Northview here out the gate still, man. I know I said it earlier, but they're hanging with North Dothan High here and making it a game for sure.
Northview has a very good team, very talented team. Tyson Williams. Tyrez Lindsay. Lindsay, nice floater.
Wow. Nice play.
He's a 10th grader.
Good length on him.
Get back. Dothan back on top by three, 13-10. Mitchell. Shot from the corner. Won't go. That was by Lee. Lindsay. Over to Williams. Into Graham. A mismatch there. Ford gets the rebound on the miss. Ford goes up.
Whoa.
What a shot. What a shot by Billy Ford.
Nice play. Important play.
And that foul was on number four, Tyrese Lindsay, his second. Ford makes the free throw. He has 6 points, 2 of 2 from the line, and we're tied up at 13 apiece. Jordan Neal in the game for the Tigers. He's a great three-point shooter. Ford goes up high on the miss. What a shot. What? Wow. Reynolds and Morris is going to be called for the foul. But Northview has a lot of speed. That would be Morris's first foul. Stay out, Cliff. Stay out, Cliff. I tell you what, Billy Ford. Well, that was that wasn't Ford. That was number five, Reynolds. He's 3 of 3 from the line. 1:24 left in the first, and Northview takes the lead, 14-13. Make it 15-13. Into the game for the Tigers, it's number 12, Kobe Baggett. Jordan Small takes a seat.
Full court press here from Northview. A little different look.
Good ball movement by the Tigers.
And looks like you don't want to press Dothan High.
That foul is on Gustavo Reynolds, and going to the line is number 20, Kevin Morris. Morris is 1 of 2 from the line with 3 points. Second foul shot by Morris. He makes 1 of 2. Northview leading by 1, 15-14, 1:11 left in the first period of play. And it's just been action-packed here in the first period.
It has. Great game so far.
Reynolds goes up. Morris goes up high and gets the rebound. The Tigers on the run. Baggett slows it down. Back over to Morris. Tyson Williams. Williams goes for a three.
Wow. That was way downtown there, Mitt.
That's 7 8 points for Williams. A steal by Dothan. Williams gets the ball. Off to Baggett. Layup is good for two. Dothan up by four. 19-15. Just under 30 seconds left in the period. Reynolds pulls up for the shot. Won't go. The big man, the butler, comes down with it. And wow, over to Jordan Neal, and it goes out of bounds, and it's a Dothan turnover.
I think Northview got a little sped up there for a few minutes and got turned over a little bit, and so Dothan High was able to capitalize.
Mitchell. Reynolds up off the glass
and
for
one.
Two. That foul is on number 32, Keyshawn Truitt. Reynolds with the basket. He's trying to make a three-point play out of it. And he does. He's perfect from the line tonight. He is 5 of 5 with 7 points. And we're almost tied. Dothan has a one-point lead, 19-18. Just over 8 seconds left in the period. And they're going to call the butler.
It looks like he took a little stutter step there.
Yeah.
He'll let you get away with that.
Hey, sir.
Tavarius
Dallas.
Butler.
No, you're on the block. Dallas. Dallas. Both of y'all. Dallas.
0.4 seconds left. So we've come to the end of one. And Dothan leads by one. The score, Dothan 19, Northview 18. We'll be back with more action after this timeout. You're watching the Scenic Sports Network. We're getting ready to start the second period of action. We're on the campus of Dothan High School, where the Dothan Tigers are taking on cross-time rivals Northview. And Cliff, it was a, as they say, a barn burner that first period.
Yeah, it was, man. It was a little bit of everything, you know.
And both of these teams are loaded. And they play hard. 3 second violation
Another
call on the Tigers. You know, turnovers really weren't a big factor in the first period.
There were a few, but it didn't seem like it was hindering either team. They were both running up and down the court relatively easy.
Billy Ford, he had a big first period.
Yeah, he did. He was all over the place.
Ford's he's a really good ball player.
It's like he was able to penetrate very well and give him a spark there for a minute and tie the ball game. But Bax will take the lead.
Right. It was right off the hands of Reynolds. I don't think he took his eye off the ball.
Yeah, I think so too.
Tyson Williams. Jordan Neal. Traveling called against number 32. That's Keyshawn Truitt.
Dothan High with a couple turnovers here. See if Northview can capitalize. Be good for him.
That time, Dothan tried to force it.
Yeah.
A.J. Williams. Shot from the corner. Yes, it's a three.
From good shot.
That's number 32, Roderick Melton. And Billy Ford steals it. Whoa! Kobe Baggett recovers and blocks the shot, but he got it with the body. So Billy Forrest going to the line. He's 2 of 2 from the line tonight. 6 points. Northview is shooting excellent from the foul line tonight. They're perfect. Yeah, 7 of 7.
That'll be big for them. You know, you got to make those 3 shots.
And Northview is going up by 2, 21 to 19. Ford misses 1 of 2. Butler. He powers his way up.
Oh, another travel on Butler.
And they call a traveling on the Butler. Dothan commits another turnover. They're scoreless in the second period. A.J. Williams.
Oh.
And an offensive foul called against Williams.
Probably a pretty good call. He had his position.
Yeah, he was a little out of control that time. He tried to force it. Kobe Baggett brings it up for the Tigers. Into Chris Graham. And it's stripped away. But Graham hustles, gets the ball back, and puts it up and draws the foul. A great effort that time by Chris Graham.
Oh, yeah, he's been real active down there, down low for him.
That foul is going to be on Justero Reynolds. Graham is 1 of 2 from the line tonight with 1 point.
More than likely not, you're going to get fouled a lot, you know, a lot more than the little guys, so it's important for them especially.
Both teams go deep on the bench. Graham makes both of his free throws, and we're tied at 21 apiece. Billy Ford. Oh, wow. Boy. Baggett saves it, and Dothan wants a timeout. So with 5:46 left in the second, we're tied at 21 apiece. Dothan inbounds the ball. Northview's in a press. And that press worked that time.
It did. That's what they designed to do. Force a long out-of-control pass. And that's exactly what it did.
We'll see if Northview can take advantage of the Dothan turnover. Melton. Sean Holmes for 3.
Wow.
That was from Walmart Southside that time.
That was pretty.
Sean Holmes with a big 3. Northview on top, and Dothan commits that second straight turnover.
Once again, the press looking pretty effective for Northview. Got Dothan and I out of sorts a little bit.
Right now, Northview's on a 6-2 run, but they turn the ball over and give it right back to Dothan. Well, this...
That was weird.
This gym is full tonight.
It is. This is about as many people I've ever seen at a high school basketball game, non-playoff.
Cliff, you mentioned earlier on our way out here to the gym that this is a game they should consider moving to the Civic Center.
They really should. I mean, multi-purpose. You know, usually give them purpose for the Civic Center, and you know, everybody's a little more comfortable. And I just think it's better to, you can split the gates between the schools. I mean, there's a lot of reasons they should do it.
Morris picks up his second foul. Cougars leading by 3, 5-11 left in the first half.
Defense.
Man wide open in the corner for a 3. And it's missed. Graham gets the rebound out to Baggett. Shot from the corner. It's good from Jordan Neal. 24-23, Northview. Traveling that time, Harris was a little out of control.
Yeah,
he lost his footing. Tyson Williams. Wow, a good defensive play that time by Harris.
A good defense from both these teams tonight, and pretty good offense for the most part. Like we said, it's a pretty high-scoring game.
Williams goes up, misses. Rebounded. Ford picks up the loose ball. Harris. I tell you what, Billy Ford is quick.
He is. He's a good player.
Hey, see my man don't hit a shot. Don't ignore. My man don't hit a shot.
That foul is on number 24, Tyson Williams, his first.
Hey, who did he foul? Somebody shoot? Are we getting the shooter out? It's 1-1. Are we getting who shot? Who was fouled? Was he fouled? Oh, Billy Ford. Okay.
Going to the line is Billy Ford. Ford is 3 of 4 from the line. 9 points. 9 points for Ford. And we have 4:15 left. Northview's leading by one.
Some kind of confusion as to who the foul is supposed to be shooting the shots, I think. They made a substitution. And I got to bring them back in.
1-3. Okay. All right. That was Terrell Harris was fouled. He'll be paying his first visit to the foul line. He makes the first. Northview back on top by 2, 25-23. Makes both of his free throws, and Northview is on top by 3, 26-23. And Cliff, so far, this has been everything we expected.
I think so. Even a little bit more than I expected. So it's a good game.
Yeah, I saw these two teams play earlier, and I saw Northview and Ashford play earlier this week, and they were operating on all cylinders.
I agree, you know, and I think Northview's press may have been a little bit of difference in this game. Earlier in the year, I watched Northview play, and they weren't really running a press, and it looked pretty good tonight. It's forced a few turnovers, and I think they need to get a roll of that.
Yeah, and Dothan is on an 11-game winning streak, so Northview would like nothing more than to put an end to that winning streak. Williams goes up, lays it in for two.
And your freshman,
Tyson Williams.
He's a nice player right there.
That foul is on number 20, Sean Holmes. Williams is 1 of 2 from the line. He has 10 points. He misses, and Johnson goes up high for the Northview rebound. Billy Ford. Shot from the corner. Won't go. Kobe Baggett rebounds it for the Tigers. Williams. Williams goes for a three. Won't go. And Small hustles and saves it. And Williams having a hard time holding on, but he finds Chris Graham open for the basket.
Wow, nice composure there by Tyson Williams to get the ball and throw it there to Graham down low. Ooh, nice play.
Johnson up. Boy, that's a bell under the basket.
There's a big guy down there.
Yeah, and Jordan Neal comes out of there with it.
Oh, and he turns it over.
Boy, Billy Ford, what a play by Ford. Billy Ford.
Ford's flying around out there, man. He's looking like a good player.
Hey, he's got a lot of speed.
He does. Does he play football too?
Yes. Northview up by one, 28-27, 2:40 left. Graham hook, yes.
That was a nice looking shot there. That's what Dothan I was looking to do is get in the paint. But I think they have a slight advantage there.
7 points for Chris Graham. Sean Holmes, in the four. And they force the turnover, Tyson Williams. Baggett goes up, won't go, rebounded by Holmes. Holmes. Melton. Dothan on top by one. Good drive to the basket by number 14, Kendrick Mitchell. That foul is on Jordan Neal, his first. He takes a seat, and to replace him is number 10, Destin Gaston. Boy, 30-29 Northview. 1:46 left in the first half. Mitchell makes a three-point play out of it. And I tell you what, Mitchell shows his speed on that play.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. There's a lot of guys with good speed out here.
You know, these are probably two of the better Dothan Northview teams we've seen in a long time.
I agree with you, especially at Northview. You know, Dothan I's been pretty good, but Northview struggles at times. And this is really a pretty good-looking team for them.
So Northview forced Dothan to commit their fifth turnover.
And like we said earlier, turnovers weren't really a factor, but it seems like now they kind of are. So kind of something to watch.
Williams is going to be called for the foul. That's his second.
Coach Brown was not very happy about that.
No, and Northview will be shooting two there in the double bonus.
Oh, man.
At the line is number 13, Terrell Harris. He's 2 of 2 from the line with 4 points. Northview up by 2, 31-29. Like I said, these two teams have played each other twice this year before this game, and they split. So it could go either way tonight.
Did you say they play each other in the Carroll tournament?
Yeah, and Northview won that one.
Really?
Northview is doing a much better job shooting free throws tonight.
Yeah, they haven't. I think they've missed one or two. I mean, that's big. You know, we've talked about that all year, and it's seeing Northview's in the lead right now. That's could be the reason why.
They're 12 or 13 from the line.
That's almost half their points.
And Harris makes a free throw. Baggett. What a move by Baggett. Kobe Baggett. 4 points for Baggett. Sean Holmes from the corner. Wide open.
Oh, three. Man.
Holmes hits his second three of the game. That gives him 6 points. And Northview, that biggest lead, 31-36. That time Baggett tried to get it in. Holmes for a three.
Yeah. Yes. Man, he's on fire.
He's smoking. An 8-point lead for Northview. Sean Holmes has come out and hit three big threes in a row. And they have Dothan on their heel. Shot, Jordan in the corner. That was Small in the corner. Northview's running.
They need to slow it down right there.
Yeah.
That was selfish. Heat check.
Wow, an 8-point Northview lead. They've had a big second period here. Boy, they have put up 20 points.
Man, that's big. Those 3-pointers really electrified Northview. That was huge for them. That was a turning point of the game for sure.
Small back to Graham. And into the big man, Butler, and he takes it in for two.
Well, they really needed that one, didn't they?
They did. Holmes for another three.
Whoa! Man, that is way deep, man.
Boy, he's got this crowd rocking.
Unbelievable.
But Dothan comes right back with a shot by Jordan Small for two.
And maybe Dothan can answer back with a 3-point play here. That'd be big for him. That kid is on fire.
Roderick Melton, that is 4 threes for Holmes, 12 points. He is on fire.
Man, that last one was almost out of bounds.
That was a pro 3-pointer.
Wow.
So, Small makes a 3-point play. 42-36.
Line three.
Man, that guy can shoot.
1 second
nine
left
three.
In the half.
Nine three.
And we've come to halftime, and Cliff, I'll tell you what, we saw enough action for an entire game in that first half.
Man, I'll tell you what, it was really something. It was a lot of fun to watch. And what can you say about Holmes coming in there and hitting those 4 3-pointers. I mean, that's been the turning point of the game so far. That's really turned Northview up a notch.
Dothan's got to find a way to slow down this Northview team. And we'll be back with more action after this timeout. Okay, we're back. Here on the campus of Dothan High School, and we're getting ready for the second half, and we have a video that we're going to show you right now.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly. Hey, 'cause I believe. Can see it, woo, then I can do it.
I can do it.
If I just believe it, there's nothing to it.
Hey, I believe I can fly. Woo. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away.
Okay, we've started the second half of action where the Dothan Tigers are trailing the Northview Cougars. And I tell you what, Cliff, that first half was, it was a hold on to your hats.
It was. You know, a lot of scoring, a lot of big plays. It was a lot of fun.
And looking at lean score, I tell you who the big factor in that first half was, number 20, Sean Holmes for Northview.
You're absolutely right. Those threes he hit, man, they were just huge. And that guy right there has been big for him, too.
Billy Ford had 9 first half points. That makes it 11 for the game. And Northview up by 8. Kevin Morris, nice move for Morris.
Big man looking good for Dothan High. I've been really impressed with their moves tonight.
And Morris is a 10th grader.
Wow, he's going to be good.
Dothan forces a Northview turnover.
Okay, kicked it.
And you'll probably see Dothan press more in the second half.
Yeah, they should. And that's usually how it goes. You know, a team that presses, they usually won't until they have to, you know.
Graham misses the shot, follows up, puts it up and in for 2. A great effort that time by Chris Graham. He had 7 first half points. That gives him 9 for the game. Sean Holmes again. Whoa!
Whoa!
Boy, number 23, Malik Johnson. Lindsay goes up.
Oh, that's misses. A bad shot.
Woo, and it's blocked.
Oh, man.
But Dothan just kept at it.
They did.
They got about 3 or 4 offensive rebounds.
Yeah, I think, like I said, Dothan High has got a little bit of a size advantage, so I think we'll see some of that start to take effect here in the second half. You know, fatigue starts to set in, and, you know, there's no fatigue when you're tall, so that never gets tired.
Tyrese Lindsay had 4 points in the first half, but he did a whole lot more.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. He's been huge for him, too. A lot of defense, a lot of rebounds. He's a good player for him.
Lindsay makes both of his free throws. And it's a 4-point game.
Dothan has clawed back a little bit.
Right now, Dothan's on a 6-4 run. Well, actually, let's see. Dothan has scored 6 points in Northview. Let's score 4. That's correct. Yep. 46-42. Northview had a double-digit lead earlier in the game. Tyson Williams goes up, misses, and is rebounded by Johnson. Holmes.
Don't leave him too much space.
Malik Johnson goes up high, puts it up and in for 2.
Nice looking shot for the big man.
4 points for Johnson here in the second half. He was scoreless in the first half. Dorothy back up. Lindsay misses. Morris gets the rebound.
Oh.
And Dothan's forced to call a timeout. So with 5:32 left in the third, 48 Northview, 42 Dothan. Small takes it out for the Tigers. Into Morris, and he goes up strong in his foul. I tell you what, he has a lot of poise for a 10th grader.
He does. You know, that's the one thing about being a good big man is how patient you can be down in the paint and wait on your shot. He does a pretty good job of that. I like the way he looks for sure. I'm sure Coach Brown likes him a lot, too.
A foul on Johnson, his second. Morris. That's 7 points for Morris. He makes both of his free throws. Holmes for
2.
That was a good feed that time from Johnson to Holmes.
I don't think he's allowed to score in increments of 2 mid. I think he has to get three.
Holmes had 12 points in the first half. And so he's trying to make a three-point play out of it. And he does, so all his points have been threes. So Northview back on top by 7. Small for a three.
I don't like misses a lot of Dothan High shots.
And good follow-up that time.
Besides
by
that one.
But Small. That gives him 5 points for the game. Northview up by 5. A.J. Williams. Billy Ford. Nice
piece. Oh.
Johnson, second effort, won't go. Third effort goes. 6 points for Johnson, all coming in the half. And a block by Johnson. That should be
Dothan's ball. It went off of Northview's foot.
Yeah, it should be Dothan's ball.
It will be, yeah.
23-10. Hey, go. Time out.
7-point lead for Northview. 4:40 left in the third, and it's a 53-46 Northview lead. Dothan inbounds the ball. Tyson Williams. I tell you, this has been a very competitive game. Nice feed into Graham. He misses, but
oh, nice.
There for the putback.
Very nice play.
8 points for Tyrese Lindsey. Northview up by 5. Holmes goes for a three.
Oh.
That was short. Kobe Baggett gets the rebound. Tyson Williams.
Come on.
Baggett, he's quick. And they call an offensive foul on Baggett.
I think I agree. He got his shoulder down a little bit. I think he got into his chest a little too much.
3:58 left in the third. 53-48. Northview. And trying to avenge an earlier loss, area loss to Dothan. And Baggett picks up another foul. It's going to be 3 on him. Going to the line is Billy Ford. He's 3 of 4 from the line tonight with 11 points. He had 9 first half points. Northview has been excellent from the foul line tonight.
Oh, yeah, that's such a big thing with these teams, you know, especially with these two teams that are playing such a high level of defense.
They're back up by 6. Ford misses the second, and it's rebounded by Lindsey. And to Lindsey. What a move by Lindsey. Up off the glass, and it won't go.
He's pretty sneaky.
That's going to be a third foul on Holmes. At the line is Tyrese Lindsey. Lindsey is 2 of 2 from the line tonight with 8 points. Into the game for Northview is Jalene Thomas, number 21.
And good
number
football
14,
player,
huh? Kendrith Mitchell. Lindsey makes 1 of 2. It's a 5-point lead for Northview, and they have led the entire third period. And Northview calls a timeout with 3:25 left in the third. Northview will be inbounding the ball. A.J. Williams. To Mitchell. Both of these teams have a lot of speed. That was off Dothan.
It looks like Dothan's coming out in some type of trap here.
Looks like they have a little disturbed there. Let's see if they can keep the pressure up.
They're going to try to force a turnover.
Well, they need to.
Nice feed over to Ford
man.
For two.
That was beautiful.
Really, Ford.
They had an answer for that.
14 points before. Williams. Lindsay. Yes.
Counting the basket.
I tell you what, Tyrese Lindsay, I am impressed with him.
Yeah, both the number fours here for both the teams are doing a lot for their respective teams.
That foul is on Mitchell. Lindsay's trying to make a three-point play out of it. But you know, the youth of these guys is what's most impressive to me.
Well, it's definitely exciting, you know, for both these teams and the city of Dothan. Maybe we can get a state champion here out of one of these guys, you know.
A great steal. And Neil missed the shot. A.J. Williams for a three. Won't go. Rebounded. And Lindsay got a hand on it. You know, I like what you said about both number fours, Billy Ford and Tyrese Lindsay. Those guys have stepped up tonight.
They are on both ends of the court, for sure.
Tyson Williams. Won't go. Rebounded. Put back. Won't go.
Oh, that's it.
Whoa.
Oh, man.
It got kind of rough on the at that time.
Yeah, a little bit.
I think the Dothan fans thought it was should have been a foul against Northview, but the Northview fans feel like the call was right.
Yeah. Well, that's the same. Dothan got a little flustered down there and couldn't handle the ball.
56-52. Northview leading. Graham goes up high and gets the rebound, and, boy, I tell you what.
I think Dothan's had a slight advantage on the boards, Mitt.
Neal for two. Big basket by Jordan Neal, and we have a two-point game. 56-54.
We got a good one brewing here. I think we're going to have a classic finish.
Billy
no! My goodness. I thought he made it.
Boy, I tell you, you're talking about exciting.
Man.
That foul is on Reynolds, and it's going to be three on him. Boy, this is a two-point game, 1:16 left in the third.
And Billy Ford got up right there. He tried to throw that one down. On about three people.
I tell you what, I like Ford.
That's an athletic kid, man. He really is. You said it before the game, and you were absolutely
Lindsay
right.
Goes in, and it's blocked, but Lindsay saves it, and he steps on the line. That block was by
I think they're going to give him for a three in the key, Mitt.
Huh?
I think they got him for 3 seconds.
Oh, 3 seconds is what it was?
Yep, Northview ball. A timely mistake for Dothan High. They need the points right there.
1 minute left in the third. 1 minute. Good defensive play, but I don't think I'll go up against Johnson. He made him change his shot. Whoa!
Oh,
foul is on Graham. And he took the worst of that one.
Oh, man, Coach Brown's so frustrated right now. It's
yeah.
A lot of sloppy play by the Tigers, but they're somehow still in it.
Into Johnson. Back to Mitchell. And a foul. That foul is on number 24, Tyson Williams, his third. Good hands by Graham. Johnson, yes. Malik Johnson, that's his eighth point of the half. Northview back on top by four, 58-54. And that foul is on Jaleen Thomas. That's three on him.
Make
26 seconds left in the third.
You know, it's interesting. Northview's backed off the full court press, but is still playing pretty effective defense. So. Yep, I knew you was about to get one. You can't push nobody. That just ain't right.
I missed that.
They got a little chippy under the goal.
32.
They exchanged pushes.
Who's the foul against?
I think it's up against both teams, as a matter of fact. But I know the Northview person pushed last. I saw that.
Who was that, number 23?
I think it was 13.
13. And at the line is number 24, Tyson Williams. He is one of three from the line tonight with 10 points, all coming in the first half.
Oh.
Williams has been struggling, and he's been struggling from the line tonight. So Williams makes one of two, and we're back to a three.
And yeah, like I said, it was a double technical. It was on both teams, so they'll both shoot technical free throws. And like I said, it was just a little push under the basket from each other. And it wasn't a big deal, but you can't let it escalate.
Well, the coach, the officials want to keep this game under control.
Absolutely, you got to. It's a rivalry, and you know it can get ugly.
A lot of emotions.
No doubt.
Holmes makes both of his. 17 points for Sean Holmes. And Northview back on top by five. And they have the ball. Mitchell for three.
Oh,
yes.
Rattles it in.
That's a big three-pointer there.
It is. Man, put him up by eight.
Yeah. Going into the fourth period.
Absolutely.
Shot from the corner. Three, and it won't go. So Northview had a big third period, putting up 21 points and Dothan 19 points. So we've come to the end of three, and the score is the Cougars 63, the Tigers 55. We'll be back with the fourth period of action after this timeout. You're watching the Scenic Sports Network. Okay, we're getting ready to start the fourth period of action. I'm not going to say the fourth and final period of action because anything can happen in this game. Northview up by eight. Dothan had cut that lead down to two, but Northview was able to stretch it back out.
And, you know, I think one difference in this game, it has been three-pointers. I mean, Northview's hit a lot more three-pointers than Dothan has.
And you're right, and they have made their free throws, too.
That's exactly right. Dothan might be 50%.
And that's the difference in this game.
Dothan has really been pretty cold from the field all night, besides what they've been able to get from their bigs off the glass and offensive rebounds. It's been pretty cold for them.
And I tell you what, Lindsay, he's going after him.
He is. He wants it.
And that foul is on Billy Ford. Morris back in for the Tigers. And at the line is Tyrese Lindsay. He's 4-5 tonight from the line.
He's actually shot pretty well for him.
With 12 points.
Nice.
Yeah, that was by Jordan Small.
Big for Dothan. Nah, they needed that.
Northview up by six.
So they're going to try to slow the tempo down here, back it out. Look for the safe shot, which is, can't blame them there.
Reynolds, nice shot.
Wow, that was a nice play.
The star of Reynolds. That gives him 9 points. Tyrese Lindsay.
Oh, what a play. Up and down. Oh, it was a push. One and one.
That foul is on number 20, Sean Holmes. That's going to be four on him. And at the line is number one, Jordan Neal. This is his first visit to the line. Holmes comes out, and in to replace him is A.J. Williams.
Both those guys have played pretty good for Northview tonight.
Oh, yes.
I think that's another difference. I think Northview's got a little bit more out of their bench tonight.
That was a big free throw that time by Jordan Neal.
Most definitely.
Back to a 7-point lead. So Northview was up by 9.
Yep.
Two big free throws coming from Jordan Neal. That's 6 points for Neal. Dothan's going to go into press and try to force some turnovers.
I'm actually surprised they haven't gone into it earlier, Mitt. Oh, and Ford with a nice play. He finishes it strong at the basket.
Billy Ford. And Morris picks up his third foul.
Nice play by Ford.
And I tell you, we talked about these number fours on both teams have just been outstanding.
That's right. I agree.
16 points for Ford. Make it 17. Neal leads the game, and back in is number 24, Tyson Williams. And it's a 9-point Northview lead.
Dothan High's getting the point. They really got to start getting some conversions down here on offense. He's running out of time here. Oh, wow. It's going to be Northview ball.
Yeah, they're going to say it was out off Morris. That's something Dothan can't afford to do right now is turn the ball over.
Really can't go. Really don't want to go down double digits here, you know.
Now this is a big game in the area because if Dothan wins, it's gonna they will win the area. But if Northview wins, it's gonna be tied. Dothan and Northview both will be tied at 2-1 in the area play.
Yeah, you know these. It's also a rivalry game and it's also an area game, so it's a really big game here tonight in Dothan.
So at the line is A.J. Williams. Williams just has one basket tonight. He had a three in the first half. Jordan Neal back into the game for the Dothan Tigers. A.J. Williams shooting 1-1. He makes the first, and it's a 10-point Northview lead. Are you a little surprised, Cliff?
I am. I'm very surprised. I really expected Dothan High to come out a little stronger here tonight.
So Dothan's got to make a run here and try to force some turnovers and stop committing turnovers.
You're right. I mean, it wasn't a big deal in the beginning of the game, but that probably should have been a carry. But the turnovers have really been costing Dothan High coming up empty down here.
Jordan Neal from the corner. He's a good three-point shooter, but he missed that one. But Northview's on the run. AJ. Great ball movement that time by Northview.
Good in the transition, too. Northview just looks really good tonight, man. I'll tell you, in all assets of the game. They're running it well. They're shooting well. They're playing good defense. They were definitely ready to play tonight.
That foul is on Neal. That's four on him. Northview up by 11, and they can make it an even dozen here. And Reynolds picks up his 10th point.
Northview kind of starting to pull away here a little bit, and Dothan High really need some energy.
Reynolds hits one of two. Morris goes up strong. Oh, go.
And that's the story for Dothan High tonight, man. They just can't get the rolls.
Ford.
Oh, that's Ford. Interference.
Ford. it's going to be Dothan's ball.
Yeah.
If we had to say anything that's the difference in this game, it's got to be the three-point shooting of Northview, especially Sean Holmes, and the free-throw shooting.
It has been. And that right there.
Was that Williams on that one, I believe it was?
I believe it was.
Boy, wow, a 14-point lead.
Wouldn't have expected this.
And Williams draws the foul, and he's fouled by Mitchell. This is kind of hard to believe here, what we're seeing.
It really is. You know,
but you know what? When these two teams play each other, you can expect anything.
It's a rivalry game. You know, that's how rivalry games go. These kids know each other. They want to beat each other. They've been playing against each other their whole lives. This is what you get. You know, some unexpected stuff.
So Williams makes one of two. It's a 13-point Northview lead with just 5 minutes left in the fourth. Good
wow.
Move. Reynolds. A three from Jordan Neal, and Dothan needed that one.
They did. They might have a little pulse here.
I tell you what, Neal can hit them, but they've got to stop Northview. They can't exchange baskets with him.
No, not right now. They got to get a stop. And they got to stop that guy right there.
That's on Kevin Morris. That's four on him. And at the line is number four, Billy Ford. He has 17 points.
Oh.
It's a 12-point Northview lead. I think Dothan's going to have to try to resort to some threes.
I think you're right.
Ford hits one of two.
Oh, man, that just can't happen. That just can't happen.
Northview, that press is pressure's getting to Dothan.
It is, it is.
Billy Ford. A.J. Williams for a three. Good jump that time by Tyrese Lindsey. Good move by the Tigers.
That's what Dothan and I needed. They can pull within single digits here if they get a stop. I mean, that'd be big for them, you know.
So Morris with the slam. And it's a 11-point lead. 4:23 left in this game, and there's still a lot of time left, Cliff.
There is. You know, this is a, like we said all along, it's a rivalry game. They come out here. That's what Northview did in the second quarter. They pulled away by hitting a couple threes. And if Dothan I could come down here and somehow get a couple threes back to back, they're right back in this thing. And they know it.
Yeah, it's been a good game tonight. I tell you what. The score will not reflect both of these teams are winners. You know, these guys have gone out and they have played their hearts out. And, you know, the scoreboard will determine who officially wins the game, but I think both teams win. They just have been really impressive tonight. Northview has just performed better. And if you really look at it, the big difference is really the free throw shooting.
It's been shooting period, Mitt. You know, I haven't seen Dothan not even hit any really mid-range shots. I mean, it's just been all around the basket for them. And they haven't been able to get anything to fall. And I think that's really been the story of the game. If they get a few more shots to fall here, it's probably a lot different ball game than what we're seeing
Dothan's
right now.
Dothan's in a four-court press. Nice feed into A.J. Williams, and Tyson Williams is going to be called for the foul. No, they're calling on number one. That's Jordan Neal, and that's going to be five on him unofficially. At the line is A.J. Williams. He's two of two from the line tonight.
you know, I also think Northview shot a lot more free throws than Dothan has.
They have, and they've made them, too.
Yeah.
And Dothan's normally a better free throw shooting team than they have been tonight. It's a 13-point Northview lead, so it's going to take some threes for Dothan. Morris shoots, gets his own rebound, goes up, misses, and a hustle by Lindsey. He saves it to Morris.
Oh, man.
And Johnson finally comes down with it. Wow. What? Oh, what some hustle. Cry.
Oh,
whoa.
Man, they can't get anything to fall.
Shot by AJ goes.
Coach Brown is very upset with the referees. He thought they really should have got fouled about three or four times down there, and they never called anything. He's giving them a little bit right now.
So A.J. Williams at the line. He's perfect from the line tonight, 4 of 4.
And Northview's pulling away here, man. That's all there is to it.
They have gone up by
16
with 3.5 minutes left. I'll tell you, and so with 3:31 left, Northview leads 81-65. So Dothan takes the ball out. They're trailing by 16 points. They led by one at the end of one, 19-18. They trailed by six at halftime, 42-36. And Northview's had a big 21-point third period, and they're up by 16 points. This is totally unexpected. Blocked by Johnson. Wide open three. Yes.
Wow, boy.
Mitchell hits his second three. That gives him 9 points for the game, and Northview is up by 19.
Unbelievable. And a technical. I think he said something. I think he might have cussed or something. They're not too shy about handing out the technicals here tonight, Mitt. You know, we saw one during the women's game, and we've seen a couple here tonight. They're keeping it in check. You got to, though.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, especially there's so many emotions in this game.
That's right. That's right.
Tyson Williams makes the first. He'll get a second. You know, Northview had a double-digit lead on Dothan when they played early, and Dothan was able to come back and win it over at Northview by 6 points. But Northview has come over here in Dothan, and they pretty much dominated the second half.
Yeah, and but I guess Northview learned from their mistake. They ain't let their foot off the gas this time.
No, they haven't. But, you know, this is a high-scoring game, Cliff.
It is. You know, they've got 84 points with 3 minutes to go. I mean, at the rate they're going, they can get 100.
Yeah, and Dothan's got almost 70.
Yeah, I mean, it really is a fairly high-scoring game for a high school basketball.
You know, because we see so many games in the 40s and the 50s.
Oh, yeah.
I like these high-scoring games.
I do, too. And it's really funny because it seems like the defense has been pretty good, but, it, you know, you look at the scoreboard and there's 80 points up there.
The defense has been good, but these are just good shooting teams.
You're right.
Morris misses. Reynolds gets the rebound. Out to four. Mitchell.
And they're just going to slow it down, looks like. Oh.
Tyrese Lindsey with a great effort. And the ball will go back to the Cougars.
It's good to see your team. You know, you're down by 15 here. It's odds are stacked against you. You're still getting on the floor after balls. You know, that's good for him, you know.
Yeah, Lindsey has had a good game tonight. I'm very impressed.
I am too.
And the thing about it, he's young. He's a 10th grader.
Yeah, they've got a, both these teams have got a bright future ahead of them. There's no question about that.
The Northview has more seniors than Dothan, but they've got some productive minutes from underclassmen.
Absolutely.
Northview's going to try to take as much time as they can off the clock. That's going to be five on Neil. Destin Gaskin back in. Billy Ford at the line. So Neil fouls out with 11 points. Billy Ford at the line. And Cliff, I keep saying, free throws have made the difference in this game.
They have. A lot more attempts, a lot more makes.
I know at the tournament, Northview missed a lot of free throws.
They did.
And tonight, they are making them. 86-68. Gaskin goes up, and he's fouled. The line is Destin Gaskin. He's scoreless tonight. I never would have thought Northview would have won by this big a margin. Neither team, really.
Me either. I'm with you. More missed free throws for Dothan High. I mean, you know, when it rains, it pours.
To the game for Dothan is Anthony Reeves. And also Keyshawn Truitt. Along with Tanner Creel. And Gaskin makes one of two. Northview leads 86-69. Mitchell loses the ball out of bounds. And he's going to be sitting down. Injury replace Terrell Harris. I tell you what, Coach Fleming didn't waste any time getting him out of there.
Two great coaches here, Mitt. I think we need to say that. These are two great basketball coaches.
Shot blocked by Johnson. 125 left. 86-69.
Right over a minute to go. And Northview's just looking to back it out and try to run some clock here. I mean, that's the obvious move.
Foul call against Gaskin. At the line is number 13, Terrell Harris. He's 4-4 from the line with 6 points. Mitchell misses, Harris misses the first. Misses both and is rebounded by Dothan. That's number two, Baxter. Boy, Northview blocked two straight Dothan shots. Malik Johnson for two. Timeout, 48 seconds, and Northview with 88 points.
You know, I think Northview's also had a lot of blocks, too, man. I mean, they're really not giving up a whole lot of points around the basket. And I know Coach Brown likes to base his game plan on getting to the basket, and so it's been a pretty tough go for Dothan High.
Yeah, it has. Northview came out, and they were just the better team tonight.
You're absolutely right. They played real good basketball.
They made the shots they needed to make when they needed to make them, and they made the free throws. And Dothan missed a lot of free throws.
Oh, yeah, no doubt about that. That's, you know, that's been one main factor is the free throws.
46 seconds left. Quill goes for a three.
Ooh.
And it's rebounded by Michael Reynolds. I tell you, I'm impressed with both of these teams.
I am too.
You know,
good looking athletes on both teams.
Dothan had a down night tonight, but
we know how good of a team they are. We've seen them. They'll be there in the end. They'll be in the state playoffs. And they don't have anything to worry about. It's just not their night. And it's unfortunate it has to come during a rivalry game. But, you know, they got a good squad. And Coach Brown will rebound from this.
And I've got to take my hat off to Northview. They came ready to play tonight.
Oh, man, that's the understatement of the year there.
And they showed up, and then they showed out.
Absolutely.
You know.
And a tough environment, too. This is a tough high school environment to be able to play in. You know, there's a lot of people.
Northview up by 20. 89.
That's going to do it.
Yeah, sure is. Northview wins at 89-69 over the Dothan Tigers. And congratulations go out to Coach Sinaskett Clemens and the Northview Cougars. So in area play, they are now tied. Both teams are 2-1.
Well, you know, that's true, man. That makes it a huge win for Northview, in the state playoff picture. You know, I mean, not to mention the rivalry game, but if you can win a game like this on the road, potentially get yourself in the playoffs. I mean, that's a big thing, you know.
Yeah. So Northview breaks Dothan 11 game winning streak.
Yeah, that's the big thing too. You know, that's kind of a sweet deal for Northview to get to knock your rival off their big winning streak. Come out. 11 games, that's a lot of games to win in a row.
Yeah, and sometimes, you know, it's good, you know, when you have a streak and you lose because it helps you to regroup a lot of time.
Yeah, you know, that's true.
It brings you back to reality.
That's exactly right. You know, I think there's some great coach who said winning is sometimes the best losing is sometimes the best medicine to make your team a little less soft, you know. So, like you said, I think this could be a good thing for Dothan High. Facing
okay.
Adversity.
Yeah. Let's recap the scoring by periods. Dothan led 19-18 at the end. And then they took a Northview took the lead 42-36 at the end at halftime, and they stretched that lead out 6-355 at the end of three. And then they win it 89-69. Now, looking at the top scores for the Dothan High Tigers, it was pretty evenly matched. Jordan Neal had 11. Tyrese Lindsay had 12. Kevin Morris, 10. Tyson Williams, 12. Chris Graham, 9. 7 from Jordan Small. And 4 from Kobe Baggin, and 2 from Tavoris Butler. For Northview, the lead score, and it was Sean Holmes who had some big three-pointers in the first half, and he came out in the second half and put up 5 more points to score 17. And A.J. Williams had 12. Billy Ford had a big night. with 18 points. Justaro Reynolds had 12. 6 from Terrell Harris. 9 from Kendrick Mitchell. 10 from Malik Johnson. And 3 from Roderick Melton to round out the scoring for the Northview Cougars. Any closing comments, Cliff, before we go? I don't guess so. No closing comments?
No, that's it. It was a pretty good game. It's a big crowd trying to get out of here. I know that.
Yeah, it was a great event tonight and a big turnout. So we want to say good night from Dothan High School, where the Northview Cougars win it 89-69. On behalf of Cliff Nyman, this is Mick Kirkland saying good night, and thanks for watching the Scenic Sports Network.